the Zelda universe is home to some interesting characters. One of the odder ones, even by Zelda standards, is Tingle. In the West at least, Tingle has never been very popular. Still, he's appeared in several games, even getting a spin-off. When he isn't busy floating around with his balloon drawing maps, or charging you exorbitant fees to translate some pointless thing, he's blasting through space, shooting money at a demon. Every time Tingle appears though, there's always something unsettling about him. You kinda just want to get every interaction with him over as quickly as possible. Sometimes though, it's important to look at the darker parts of ourselves, and to try and understand him a little better. So, today's question, what's the deal with Tingle? Short answer, he's just some weirdo, and the less said about him the better. After all, there must be a reason he ended up in prison. Long answer? If you look at it in a certain way, Tingle is actually rather tragic. First, what do we know about Tingle? Most of the information we have comes from Majora's Mask, which is also the first game he appears in. To me, Majora's Mask is very personal, in that a lot of it deals with how Link sees himself, with much of the game representing some part of his inner world. So, what does Tingle mean to Link? Unlike a lot of people in Termina, Tingle doesn't seem to be based on anyone Link has met before. So, bit of a stretch, but what if Tingle is based on Link himself? Hear me out. One way of looking at it is that Tingle is a sort of twisted parody of Link, from his familiar way of dressing in green, to his oddly disturbing characterization. This could be how Link sees himself in his darker moments. Or perhaps Tingle is Link's fear of failure, an image of what he sees himself becoming if he isn't able to conquer his own demons. The first thing to consider is that Link and Tingle are actually very similar. Back at the beginning of Ocarina of Time, Link is described as the boy who does not have a fairy. This makes him different from the Kokiri he lives with. We know that Link eventually does get a fairy, for better or worse, but you can imagine that it wasn't easy for a young child to grow up being marked out like that. It's easy to think of Link as lonely, wondering why he's the only one that a fairy hasn't come to yet. Maybe some of that sticks with him, because after Navi leaves at the end of Ocarina of Time, the young Link begins a quest to find her, which inadvertently kicks off the events of Majora's Mask. So one of the things that really stays with Link is, well, he wants to have a fairy. And this is basically what Tingle wants. Unlike Link, however, he was never visited by one, even though he waited and waited. And now, age 35, he's become something of an obsessed weirdo. You can't help but wonder if Link sees Tingle as something of a kindred spirit. Certainly Tingle seems to think of Link this way, saying that he is the same as Link. Could it be then that Link sees Tingle as an image of what he might have become if Navi had never visited him, and what he might still become if he fails to find her? Not a hero marked out by destiny, but just a lost boy, caught up in his own dreams. This brings us onto the second point. Tingle, despite being a middle-aged man, is strangely childlike, and seems to live in his own little fantasy world. And in a way, Link isn't much different. Link's own age is rather ambiguous. He has the body of a young boy, but during the events of Ocarina of Time, he went through quite a bit, so you could say that he is older than he looks. Link also grew up among the Kokiri, who never age, and look like young children forever. If he had stayed with them, would he have ended up the same as Tingle? A ridiculous middle-aged man amongst children trying desperately to fit in? Think of this as well. At the end of Ocarina of Time, Zelda sends Link back to his childhood. No one here knows of the good he did. No one knows that he was the hero who saved them. Only him. If so, then is Link really who he thinks he is? Do people look at him the same way they look at Tingle? Just some weirdo who really needs to grow up and stop playing at being a hero? These are all questions that Link needs to confront, and in the character of Tingle he can, in a sense, come face to face with these doubts and fears. What would he be if he failed? And what would he be if he wasn't who he thought he was? It's these things, I think, that make Tingle a very interesting, if also a very disturbing character. So there you have it. Tingle, at least at first, is a sort of dark mirror to Link. Tingle can be understood as representing some of Link's fears, a tragic image of who he might become if his life doesn't go quite right. And that's scary. After all, you don't want to end up being this guy, do you? Sometimes though, it's important to face up and acknowledge what failure looks like. Not to scare us, but to motivate us to keep moving forward. Seems to have worked for Link. Maybe it'll work for us as well.